The third chapter, kinetic theory of gases and radiation. In this lecture, we will study about emission of heat radiation and about Kirchhoff's law of heat radiation. Emission of heat radiation. According to Prevost's theory of heat exchange, all the bodies at all the temperatures above 0 Kelvin radiate thermal energy, and at the same time they absorb radiation received from the surroundings. That is, every body simultaneously emits and absorbs heat radiations at all the temperature other than the absolute zero. Suppose we have a pen. This pen is at a temperature greater than 0 Kelvin. Then this pen emits heat energy at the same time it absorbs heat energy, thermal energy, heat radiations from the surrounding. Second, the amount of thermal radiation emitted per unit time depends upon the nature of emitting surface, that is, whether the surface is rough or polished, its surface area and temperature of the body. This energy which is emitted per unit time depends upon these three factors. The first factor, it is the nature of emitting surface. Second, its surface area. And third, its temperature. Hotter bodies radiate at higher rate than cooler bodies. When the temperature of the body is high, then it radiates, emits at higher rate. If the temperature of the body is less, then it radiates at less rate. Light colored reflects most, while the dark colored object absorbs most. Now, for a body, the absorbed radiation increases kinetic energy of the constituent atoms oscillating about their mean positions. That is, when body absorbs heat radiations, it is received by the atoms of the body. The atoms receive thermal energy and the amplitude of vibration increases. We know that the atoms in a body are vibrating about their mean positions. When these atoms receives thermal energy, then they begins to vibrate with maximum amplitude. As the amplitude of vibrations of the atoms increases, their kinetic energy increases. Therefore, their temperature increases. Because we know that average translational kinetic energy is the measure of temperature of the body. If body absorbs energy, there is increase in the temperature of the body. If body radiates, emits heat energy, then there is decrease in the temperature of the body because its thermal energy decreases. If the heat radiated is greater than heat absorbed, temperature decreases. When the rate of absorption of radiation is equal to the rate of emission of the radiation, then temperature of body remains same. That is, if the temperature of the body is greater than the room temperature, then body radiates more heat than what it absorbs. Temperature of body, it is greater than surrounding temperature, room temperature. Therefore, body radiates more heat than what it absorbs. Therefore, there is net loss in the heat energy of the body and its temperature decreases. After some time, this body will be in thermal equilibrium with the surrounding. That is, body attains the same temperature as that of the surrounding. If the temperature of body is less than room temperature, then body absorbs more heat energy than what it radiates, emits. Therefore, there is net gain in the heat energy of the body and temperature of the body increases. After some time, body will attain the same temperature as that of the room temperature. It is in thermal equilibrium with the surrounding. At room temperature, the thermal radiation corresponding to wavelengths longer than those of visible light. Hence, we do not see them. As the temperature is less, the wavelength of the emitted radiation is high. We know that the visible light is in the range of wavelength that is in between 4000 angstrom to 8000 angstrom. This wavelength is greater than 8000 angstrom minute. Therefore, we cannot see them. When body is heated, its temperature increases. The radiated energy corresponds to shorter wavelengths. That is, the temperature is around 800 degrees centigrade. Part of the energy emitted is in the visible range and body appears red. At 3000 degrees centigrade, it looks white hot. Filament of tungsten appears white hot at 3000 degrees centigrade. Now, the amount of heat radiated by the body depends upon, first, the absolute temperature of the body, second, the nature of the body, that is material, nature of the surface, whether it is polished or rough, third, surface area of the body, and fourth, the time duration for which body emits the heat radiation, that is T. This energy emitted, heat energy emitted by the body depends upon these four factors. The first factor is absolute temperature of the body. If body have maximum temperature, higher temperature, then it emits more heat energy. Second, the nature of the body, that is the material and nature of the surface, whether it is polished or rough. Polished surface emits less heat energy. Rough surface emits higher heat energy. Rough surface absorbs more heat energy, therefore it emits, radiates more heat energy. Third, surface area of the body. If the surface area of the body is large, then body radiates large amount of heat energy. And last, the time duration for which body emits radiation. The amount of heat radiated Q is directly proportional to the surface area A and time duration T. That is Q, it is the amount of heat radiated. It is directly proportional to the surface area A and directly proportional to the time duration T. That is Q is directly proportional to A into T. That is Q, it is equal to R A T. Therefore, R it is equal to Q divided by A T. If A it is equal to 1, T it is equal to 1, then R it is equal to Q. This R, that is the constant of proportionality, it is called as emissive power. Thus, emissive power is defined as the amount of radiant heat emitted per unit area per unit time at the given temperature. R, that is the emissive power of a body, is defined as the amount of radiant heat emitted per unit time per unit area at the given temperature. This emissive power R, it is equal to Q, that is the amount of heat emitted, divided by A, that is the area, surface area of the body, and T, it is the time interval. R, it is equal to Q divided by AT. Now, units of emissive power. SI unit, it is energy, it is measured in joule, surface area in square meter, and time interval in second. SI unit is joule per square meter second. We know that joule per second, it is watt. Therefore, SI unit of emissive power is watt per meter square. CGS unit, earth per square centimeter second. Now, the dimensions of emissive power are, it is equal to dimensions of heat emitted divided by dimensions of area and dimensions of time interval. R, it is equal to Q divided by A into T. Therefore, writing the dimensions of energy, 2 in length, 1 in mass, minus 2 in time. Dimensions of area, 2 in length, 0 in mass, 0 in time. Dimensions of time interval, t, 1 in time. Rearranging these dimensions, L square get cancelled. This 1, it is taken to the numerator, minus 2, minus 1. Becomes minus 3, therefore dimensions of emissive power are 0 in length, 1 in mass, minus 3 in time. The nature of emitting surface is not a physical quantity. At the given temperature, a perfectly black body has maximum emissive power. It is convenient to compare the emissive power of any object, any surface, with that of the emissive power of perfectly black body at the same temperature. Coefficient of emission or emissivity. The comparison of emissive power of any object, any surface with the emissive power of perfectly black body at the same temperature gives us a new quantity. It is called as coefficient of emission or emissivity. The coefficient of emission or emissivity E of a given surface is defined as the ratio of emissive power R of the surface to the emissive power RB of perfectly black surface at the same temperature. Therefore, E it is equal to R divided by RB. R it is the emissive power of the given surface. RB it is the emissive power of a perfectly black body. E it is equal to R divided by RB. Being the ratio of two similar quantities, that is of the thermal energy, E has no unit and no dimensions. We know that the perfectly black body radiates more, that is R it is equal to RB for perfectly black body. Therefore, perfectly black body coefficient of emission E it is equal to 1. For perfect reflector E it is equal to 0, because R perfect reflector E coefficient of emission is 0 because it is the poor radiator, poor emitter. Therefore, E it is equal to 0 for perfect reflector. In general, ordinary bodies radiate at a rate less than that of the black body at the same temperature. For these bodies, the rate depends upon the properties such as color and composition of the surface in addition to the temperature. Therefore, for these bodies, that is for ordinary bodies, E lies in between 0 and 1. It is greater than 0 and it is less than 1. For example, for copper, it is equal to 0.3. For coal, it is equal to 0.8. For stainless steel polished, it is equal to 0.07. For cotton cloths, it is equal to coefficient of emission, it is equal to 0.77. For concrete, it is equal to 0.85. For cement, it is equal to 0.5. Emissivity is larger for the rough surfaces and smaller for the smooth or polished surfaces. Polished surfaces are perfect reflector, therefore they radiate less. Hence, for smooth and polished surfaces, the coefficient of emission has a small value. This emissivity, that is the coefficient of emission, varies with temperature and wavelength of the radiation. Kirchhoff's law of heat radiation. Statement: at a given temperature, the ratio of emissive power to coefficient of absorption of a body is equal to the emissive power of a perfectly black body at the same temperature and for all the wavelengths. That is, the ratio of emissive power of any object to its coefficient of absorption always remains the same, and it is equal to the emissive power of a perfectly black body at the same temperature and for the same wavelength of radiation. Suppose we have a pen. The emissive power of pen is R and its coefficient of absorption is A. Then ratio of R to the A is constant at the given temperature and it is equal to the emissive power of a perfectly black body at the same temperature. We have different objects which are at same temperature and for the same wavelength of radiation, the ratio of this R to the A always remains constant and it is equal to the emissive power of a perfectly black body at the same temperature. Therefore, RB it is equal to R divided by A. Rearranging this equation, A it is equal to R divided by RB. We know that R it is the emissive power of a body. RB it is the emissive power of a perfectly black body. The ratio of emissive power of a body to the emissive power of a perfectly black body is the coefficient of emission, emissivity E. Therefore, A it is equal to E. Hence, coefficient of absorption it is equal to coefficient of emission. More specifically, for given wavelength, that is A lambda, it is equal to E lambda. For a body emitting and absorbing thermal radiation in thermal equilibrium, the emissivity is equal to the absorptivity. If a body has a high emissive power, it also has a high absorptive power. Theoretical proof of Kirchhoff's law. We have two bodies, A it is the ordinary body and B it is the perfectly black body, having identical in geometrical shapes, that is they have same surface area, are enclosed in a constant temperature enclosure. Let R it is the emissive power of a body A, RB it is the emissive power of a body B, A it is the coefficient of absorption of ordinary body A, E it is the coefficient of emission of ordinary body A. Let Q it is the quantity of radiant heat incident on each body per unit time per unit area. Now these bodies A and perfectly black body B have the same temperature as that of the temperature of enclosure. We know that when body is are having the same temperature, then body emits and absorbs the same amount of heat energy, that is the rate of absorption and rate of emission remains same. Now for ordinary body A, the quantity of radiant heat absorbed by the body, that is QA, is given by QA it is equal to A into Q. We know that A that is the coefficient of absorption, it is equal to heat absorbed divided by heat incident. Therefore, heat absorbed it is equal to A that is the coefficient of absorption into Q, that is the heat incident. Therefore, heat absorbed by the ordinary body A per unit time per unit area, it is equal to A into Q. As the body B is perfectly black, it absorbs all the radiant heat incident upon it. As the temperature of body A and temperature of perfectly black body B remains the same, both must emit the same amount as they absorb in unit time. Therefore, for body A, the quantity of radiant heat absorbed by the body A per unit time per unit area, it is equal to quantity of heat emitted by the body A per unit time per unit area. We know that the quantity of heat emitted by the body per unit time per unit area is its emissive power. Therefore, for body A, AQ, that is the heat absorptive power, is equal to the emissive power, that is equal to R. That is, for body A, the absorptive power AQ, it is equal to emissive power R. we have equation AQT is equal to R. Let it be equation 1. For perfect black body B, the quantity of radiant heat absorbed by the body B per unit time per unit area is equal to quantity of heat emitted by the body B per unit time per unit area. That is, as it is perfectly black body, it absorbs all the radiant heat incident upon it, that is Q. It is equal to emissive power of perfectly black body, that is RB. We have second equation, Q, it is equal to RB, dividing equation 1 by equation 2, that is AQ divided by Q, it is equal to R divided by RB. This AQ divided by Q, it is equal to R divided by RB. QQ get cancelled. A, it is equal to R divided by RB. Or rearranging this equation, R divided by A, it is equal to RB. This is the statement, mathematical statement of Kirchhoff's law. R divided by A, it is equal to RB. Again, R divided by RB, it is equal to coefficient of emission E. Therefore, A, it is equal to E. That is, coefficient of absorption is equal to coefficient of emission. Thus, Kirchhoff's law is theoretically proved. Now, the applications of Kirchhoff's law. In desert, days are hot and nights are cold. Now, sand is rough black, so it is good absorber, and hence in deserts they will be very hot as the radiation from the sun is incident on the sand. Now, in accordance with Kirchhoff's law, good absorber is a good emitter, so nights will be cold when sand emits radiation. This is why days are hot and nights are cold in deserts. Second, a person with black skin experiences more heat and more cold compared to a person of white skin, because when the outside temperature is greater, the person with black skin absorbs more heat, and when the outside temperature is less, the person with black skin radiates more energy. Therefore, a person with black skin experiences more heat and more cold compared to a person of white skin.